Okay, great. Welcome to the Real Nonsense Podcast. This is the Real Nonsense Podcast with Dr. Christopher Rogers and Melody J. Walker.
Hey.
And today, our special guest is, can I get the music? What my theme song, DJ?
What's going on? Let's go, people. Let's go, big good people. Let's go.
Hey. So look, we turned all the way up today. It's the Real Nonsense Podcast. And our special guest today is Okiymo, Manica, counselor, DJ, relationship counselor. She does the whole nine yards. So the Real Nonsense Podcast is sponsored by Melodic Retirement Services. Prepare for your future today. For more information or to make an appointment, call Melody J. Walker at 248-301-2439. That's 248-301-2439. Retire healthy and wealthy. Okay, so let's get it. Okiymo, what's up, DJ?
What up, though?
Hey, so listen, we're going to turn up today. We're going to have a good time today. We want to talk to you, let our audience know who you are, what you do, and all of that. So listen, the first thing I said is you are a counselor in the Detroit Public Schools Community District. That's correct?
Yes.
And how long have you been a counselor? Tell us about your journey in education.
All right. So first things first, Kent, is the music at its pace? Is it need to turn down a little bit, or you're okay?
I don't know, man. Are we good? We rocking. We good with the music?
Yeah.
We good. Okay.
Yeah, okay. So, man, I can go way back. So, of course, I'm a graduate of DPSC.
Wonderful. What high school?
So I was Northern High School.
Northern High School, the old Northern. Okay.
Yeah, it was an awesome teacher, Mr. Williams, who got me a summer job, and I worked as a secretary at Northern High School.
Okay.
Fast forward, I had that same ID when I became an ed tech.
Wow.
So that's the educational technician. It was the same ID, which was a blessing for me because I didn't have to wait a long time to get paid because I was already in the system with that ID. So I went from an ed tech to a certified teacher, 6th through 12th grade. I went back to my home school as an ed tech. That was Davidson Elementary. I did my student teaching at Northern High School. Okay. Keeping it in the family, right?
Hey, man.
Yes, I love my DPSCD family and the students. And so I did a shift. It was still in education, but I felt like a lot of the students would talk to me. Like, I'll teach, but it was more talking, you know, building those relationships. And they had some real issues, you know what I'm saying? So I sat back and I'm like, I keep being laid off. I must got changed some things, so I prayed about it, and it was counseling. And so I attended Wayne State University. I registered in 2013. I had some bumps and bruises along the way, but I said, Lord, you didn't bring me this far to lead me, okay?
Absolutely.
So 2019, I graduated. 2018, I did my internship at Bethune.
Wow.
And so, yeah, it worked out because I was able to get paid. You know how some internships are free. I was able to get paid because I passed the test, the counselor certification test prior to graduation. So it worked out. And I've been there ever since. And I love it. 4 years. This will be my fourth year.
Wow.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
So yeah, because you persevered. So you said you went to teach and then you decided through prayer that counseling was your niche.
Mm-hmm.
So for the counselor, I guess that in teaching, I know because at any given time, you are going to be called to the carpet to maybe counsel a kid, teach a kid something. But how is like teaching and counseling like very different in terms of like how you service, you know, the children at Bethune? Is it more personal, you know, more engaging?
So, just like you said, I like when you said different. And it is different to a certain point. However, I still have to do lessons, you know what I'm saying? But I do have that one-on-one, like you were saying, it's more personal.
Yeah.
And so every moment is a teachable moment.
Yeah.
That's what counseling is. Every moment is a teachable moment. But just to be able to do it with that one-on-one or sometimes as a group. And one thing I do first before I do anything with the kids, I love on them.
We talked about that.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about that. Love on them. Is that a hug? That's
how. Yeah, that's so my thing is, it's not much of a hug. What people don't understand is saying kind words.
Yeah.
Right.
Kind words like, you know what? You are so awesome. And they'll look at me like, man, auntie. I'd be like, you the bomb.com. You know, you're going to be something amazing when you grow up.
Yeah.
And then I get into it. Like I'll say, what brought you in today? That's exactly how I do it. What brought you in today? And some of them will be like, I don't even know. And then some of them like, well, you know what happened was.
Yeah. What, so how's it been like being a school counselor during this pandemic? Like, what has that been like being a counselor? Because for a long time they weren't there, but you were still supporting them, right?
Nope, we wasn't there. And so I was very concerned during the pandemic because, you know, a lot of situations happen at home, unfortunately.
Yeah.
A lot of violence, a lot of abuse, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It happens in the home. So I would tell people, you know, believe it or not, a school is a safe haven for many children. Definitely. So I would do like wellness calls when we were on virtual. I created videos because they love videos and I love being in the video, in the camera. So I created videos on like Calm Classroom, you know, like breathing techniques and things like that. That was straight, you know, from the district using our district tools to help our children. I have to teach expect respect. So those are the character traits.
Right.
So for example, honesty is one is month. So what I did, even though I'm back face to face, I still did a video. I still did a video in my office about honesty. So they, you know, I don't want them to get away from it because we, believe it or not, it's been a blessing as well as, you know, we had our ups and downs, but our children, believe it or not, are more equipped now.
Yeah.
Some people are like, oh, they're going to turn out, they're going to be sour, they're going to be terrible. And I'm like, what? Some of y'all don't even know how to send an email. These children know how to send an email. They can type in the using all the technology with the computers. Yeah. I have a student and she's amazing. She's in because I do an after school program too. Okay. She sets up Zoom meetings.
Wow.
And she's like 8. She sets up Zoom meetings. And she used to say, especially when we was virtual, she'd say, Miss O, don't forget, we're meeting at lunchtime. I'd be like, girl, send the link to me. Send the link to me. And she will set up the Zoom meeting and she'll say, what would you like to do today, Miss O?
Wow.
And I'm like, okay, what you want to do? And she'll say, let's do Jeopardy. So we will have, she will, now you know with Jeopardy, it's not a game that's already set up. You have to create it. You have to create the questions. You have to create the answers. And that is all, I'm telling you, you got adults who struggle with that.
For sure. No, these kids are very, very, very talented. And I look at even like I have an 11-year-old daughter. She's way more advanced than I am, you know, with our devices and all these things. So, and I like what you said about COVID making them more equipped. Because I think it made everybody, you know, hopefully it made everybody more equipped, but definitely our students, you know, having to transform between in-person and virtual, having to keep an attention span, you know, to learn, you know, and kind of stay ahead. So that's great. So where's the music?
Girl, I couldn't hear a little.
I don't hear no music.
I couldn't hear a little. I was just like,
oh, you couldn't hear a little. Okay.
So I'm good now.
So you've kind of always been really at middle school level. I love middle school. I thought middle school was so rewarding because, you know, you get to see them grow. You get to see the light bulbs come on all the time. So is that your comfort zone? You like being at the middle school, elementary level? That's kind of where you like to rock?
To be honest, I'm a high school person.
Okay.
But, you know, one of my fellow leaders was like, you know, you need to be with the babies. Because I would baby my high school students, but it wasn't that I was babying them. Believe it or not, we pay more attention to K-8 students than we do our high schoolers.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
We figure, oh, they got it. Well, to be honest, they still kind of struggling.
They're struggling. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah.
They need just as much support now because it's additional stuff coming to them.
Right.
You know, so I end up back into the K-8 setting, which I brought my children. So I was used to going to the high school building, my children going to their building. Then I had to combine my children and job. I was like, really? Yeah. Is this really happening? So, you know, I have friends, they'll be like, well, look at it like this. They with you. It should be a little easier. But it was a challenge because I didn't want it. And that's what people have to understand. What might look good to somebody else can be a huge challenge. And being able to adapt yourself to these new changes, just like in going back to, you know, COVID. We are now adapting ourselves because this is a new world for us.
Right.
And if we're barely making it through, how you think our baby's doing? How you think those teenagers are doing?
How you think they're doing? Yeah. Hey, I see the necklace there. Okay. Uh-oh. Sigma Gamma Rho. Okay. I see the necklace. Period. Just
our
period, huh?
Okay.
Yeah. So I wore my shirt today just to
represent
too,
new. You know, yo. Come
yeah,
on.
I just kind of wanted to represent a little bit.
All right, y'all.
So
Dina.
So listen. So school day runs this course. Then you put the cape on, and you're doing two things, right? So, you know, like I used to say, I was the hardest working man in show business, but you doing relationship counseling. You got a podcast, Okiymo, the counselor, the podcast. And then the sign back there. Can you hold that sign up to the camera so everybody can see what that is, please? So DJ Quad.
Okay.
So here we go. So we on the ones and twos, right? In addition to being a counselor. Crazy. So how did you even get into that?
During the pandemic, with my extrovertness. I'm trying to tell you.
Everybody got a business during the pandemic. Blessed a lot of people.
It sure did. So all I can say is, the pandemic pushed me. It pushed me. It because I was so used. I'm used to being around people. So now I'm not at work.
Yeah.
I'm not taking selfies with my kids. You know what I'm saying? I'm not not have any human interaction. So what I used to do was to get myself through, I would go on Facebook Messenger, call up my sorority sisters and my D9 family, and we will talk on Messenger. And then I'd be like, I'm the DJ, y'all. Let me play some music. And then that's how it came. It came like that. And so to bring it fully to me, I was at a friend of mine. We would have battles on who playlist was, you know, lit the most, right? So who playlist was lit the most? Here we go. I'm like, man, so he had put me on with some music or whatever. So I was watching YouTube. Chris Brown was on there. He was dancing his little soul out. And I sat there, this was on Father's Day. I was like, you know what? I'm about to become a DJ.
You know what, Okiymo? But it's so like profound because what you tapped into was a wave of what people needed in COVID to feel good. Mm-hmm. And I, my mom was showing me, like, she had sent me like live DJ from DJ Vega out of New York.
Okay.
And all that like Spanish reggae, like Afrobeat music, but they would just go on into a room and play like 2 hour sets. And people would log in and just party. And so what you tap into is a wave of what people needed to do to feel good during COVID, but now it's transcending to your hustle or your nighttime job or your party job. And it's just like, we needed it. People need that. We need things that make us feel good.
Mm-hmm. Versus came out during the pandemic, right? Didn't Versus start during the pandemic?
Yes.
Right. I think so. Oh, yeah, the Versus.
Okay. Versus started. Man, I can remember I have a... D9 brother and Lecrae, shout out to Lecrae.
Yeah,
Dennis was like, you know, why we having these DJ battles? Mm-hmm. And I'm like, what? He said, you want to be a part of it? Mm-hmm. I'm like, I'm so scared, I don't know what to do, y'all. They was like, it was DJ Davey Wonderboy, period. What up, Doll Sigma? And DJ Hollywood, you know, bless his soul, he went on to heaven this year. So between us three was the battles. And so people will be like, oh my God, a female? That's all I kept hearing. Like, she representing us. I see you. When I DJ with children parties, they be looking like, that's a girl, mommy. That's a girl. And I'm like, come on over here. Let's get this picture. I put them up to the DJ, my DJ setup right here, and I show them, and I walk them through. So part of one of my other hats I wear is I work for Crescendo Detroit, which is an awesome music program. Mm. So they said, Miss O, what you want to do for the summer for the children? I'm naming financial literacy, right? Because I teach that too. But at school. They said, no, we want something fun and hype. Why don't you DJ? Why don't you teach them how to DJ? So I was blessed to teach 26 children this summer.
Wow.
They all got DJ names. They know exactly how to set up the equipment. They know what to do, y'all.
That's what I'm talking about.
That's, you know, beautiful.
It's kind of funny, you know, being graduating from high school in the 80s when rapping first came out, Run DMC, all of that. And you see the real, you see the vinyl, right? Straight vinyl, guys on turntables and all that. Then you see on MTV DJ contests. And then now it's like total MPEG, everything, the vinyl's gone. So now it's everything is, you know, like how do you feel about that kind of shift? Like, have you ever done it, the vinyl part, or you've only done it the way you have it now, where everything...
Oh, man, let me tell you. When I see the vinyl, because, of course, I'm around... Oh, before we go there, I got a shout-out of Andre Williams, DJ Furious. He's an alpha. He's the one that taught me, sat with me and taught me how to DJ.
Okay.
So I have to shout, give him his kudos, give him his flowers, because he was like, sure. And we met up, and it only took like one session, and I was good.
Okay.
So I have to say that. I have to give that to him. And he taught me on this DDJ SB3. That's how he taught me. Okay. Now, when I'm around DJs like DJ Bass, DJ Snake, DJ Esquire, DJ Principal Marty Bolger. Now, okay. Bolger.
Hold on. I just found out Marty Bolger DJ.
Man, Marty Bolger, all of the ones I'm naming is legends. Wow. Like, I met DJ Gary Chandler. We didn't took pictures together. DJ Fingers. We didn't took pictures together.
Wow.
DJ Too Cheesy. He helped me out. Another house DJ. It's so many DJs. I'm sitting up here like, I don't want to forget anybody, but they know.
I went to school with a good. I went to school with a good DJ, Rick Wilhite.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So he's a house DJ too. Mm-hmm. He's off the hook.
So just to watch their vinyl is just like, wow, that's dope. Like, they don't have to bring the records anymore, but it's the way it's just set up. But all of those came from crates, straight crates. Shout out to the crate carriers.
Right.
Amen.
Shout out to the I'm serious.
I mean, it seems like that takes a lot of skill. And I've stood there and watched DJs and bars, and I'm like, man, to move those, scratch those records and go back and forth with the fader, like, that takes a lot of work.
It does. Now, what has happened now, the transition to technology is more like loading, saving your information so you won't use it, backing it up so you won't mess up. Because, man, I got a lot of music. I don't have as much as, you know, others, but I got enough. And one thing about the DJ world, they look out for one another. We support one another. We look out for one another.
What so, kind of music do you like to play, or DJ? What kind of music are you into? Or are you like,
well, me personally, I'm a little ratchet. I'm just saying.
Yeah, I love ratchet.
I'm the people's DJ. I am the people's DJ. I try to play a little bit for everybody. Even when I do Sweet 16, I have to let, you know, remind the 16-year-old that these children just didn't get here in their own cars.
So it's different. It's different levels of ratchet. So it's Too Short, Too Live Crew, Poison Clan ratchet.
Cardi B. You heard?
Okay, so that's a different ratchet. Cardi B is a different kind of
Megan,
ratchet.
Yeah. I mean, body yada yada. I'm just saying. So, okay. Hot Summer Girl. I like
Megan
that.
Stallion.
I like all music.
Yeah.
Because all music does something different for you. Music does something different.
Well, to be a good DJ, you gotta really kind of like all music, right?
That's why I say I'm a DJ for the people, because it's not my show.
What kind of events do you most? Like, some people do a lot of weddings, some people do a lot of house parties. What do you do most?
Man, I think I have a balance. So why I say that? Because I'm an interactive DJ. Like, I just don't sit behind here. I'm with the crowd. So if they hustling, I'm hustling. If they ballrooming, I'm ballrooming. You know, so I've done, listen, I told you I started this during the pandemic. I have done over 50 events.
Wow.
I sat back and I look at things and I write stuff down. I'm like, wow, who does that? Who's even able to do that? So, like I said, I'm the DJ for the people. I do community events. I've done like 4 weddings.
What about your school?
My school, they have an experience. Oh, let me tell you, during COVID, I was the virtual DJ. So we have fun Friday. So fourth Friday of each month, they had DJ Quad.
Wow.
Every fourth Friday during the pandemic.
So that must blow the kids' mind that you go from concert to DJ.
My goodness. And that's the great. Kindergartners and the first graders are mostly.
I bet. Okay. so we should hear something. Let's hear something. Let's do a little mix for us.
Do a little mix. Let's go. So here we go.
Hey.
Remember I told you about some house?
Yeah.
So I'm going to do a little house.
I like house music. House music is really great. Really gospel music, right?
I love house.
Hey.
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 All right, for the listening world, let's go.
Hey.
Hey. Who is that, Okiymo? Okay.
My latest.
Okay.
Thank you.
This is the Real Nonsense Podcast with DJ Quad, aka Okiymo, the counselor.
He's doing our thing.
Right.
I mean, house is a real thing.
Oh yeah, that's the real deal.
Thing, like it's part of going all night long.
And I don't think I've ever heard that song before. And
they got gospel music in house form. I mean, they cover everything. It's a house.
Yeah, I've never heard that rendition of that song ever like that.
Yeah, that's dope.
Wow, yeah.
I was trying to find yo work it out.
Okay. Oh.
Cause they got it in the mix.
Love it. It's really a party now. Nah. Let's get lit. It's a party. Hey. So I think this is the perfect time for me to do this ad right quick, right? So for the finest professional photography services of all types in the metropolitan Detroit area, contact Jared Davis Photography, where we make the magic the world wants to see. Call Jared Davis at 567-343-1980. Again, Jared Davis Photography, our sponsor, 567-343-1980. Let's go.
That's the one I was looking for you, Mel.
What?
Work it out.
Okay.
Work it out. Work it out.
Hey, it's a party in here. The real nonsense. With DJ Quad.
Tap in with your girl. DJ Quad, making your body move with these smooth and hype jabs.
Wow. Take them wherever they need to go today. Take them wherever they need to go.
Here we go. Let's go.
Hey. Okay, I wasn't expecting teaching that.
You know what? I've never done it. I've never seen it before. So I don't, I don't know how to, you know, like, how do I break that down? Like,
found it.
Oh, it's getting there. It's getting there. You're taking it there. You taking it there, Clyde.
Yeah.
We there today.
Yes. That was fun.
Yeah. That's what we do. We have fun. That's what we do. That's what we do. That's what we do. That's what we do.
And then so shout out. It's one female DJ. I got two. One is DJ Lady. Lady T, DJ Lady T.
Yes.
She's an AKA. Okay. And then I have I have a house DJ. I see her face. Sexy Sauce, DJ Sexy Sauce.
Okay.
Yeah, she be at that. What's one of the spots that's in Royal Oak? I think it's in that they play a lot of house music. Friends is house music on Thursdays.
Okay.
And then Wednesdays house music. Bosco's.
Okay.
So look, Okiymo, I'm gonna ask you a couple rapid fire questions. Like, I'm gonna ask you the question, you get one answer, we go to the next question, right? So I'm gonna ask you a series of questions. Okay, so best music to DJ, house music, rap music.
You said what?
Best music, house, rap.
Oh man, that's so tough. Rap, it's so tough, it's so tough.
As a DJ, the best dancers you see, women or men?
The best DJ?
The best dancers.
Best dancers?
When you DJing, out.
Women?
Mm-hmm. Best venues, inside or outside?
Oh, man. More room outside.
Weekends or weeknights?
Definitely weekends. But if you can bring the crowd, they will come out.
Air conditioned or hot and sweaty venue?
What did he say?
Hot house. Look, he's talking about, he said air conditioned or hot and sweaty.
Man, you better have some air. Unless you're trying to get people to leave. I can't. Manager.
Young crowd, millennial crowd or older crowd?
My season, people, my season. Even though people? I cater to everybody, but my old, they like, she know what to do. Like, it's almost like I'm in the house with my friends. If I can say it like that.
Yeah. So what do you think as a DJ? I can only imagine what being a counselor has provided for you as a person, right? Mm-hmm. But being a DJ, what has that provided for you on a personal level? Like being a DJ, what has that provided for you personally? From money.
It has caused me to be very creative. Mm-hmm. Customer service is my most important thing. Customer service. I love people. It's not my show. It's your show. I want to make sure everything is on the up and up, that I draw. Because they hired me to do me. But I want to make sure that they are happy.
Right.
And that their guests left satisfied.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, so go ahead, Mel.
Say that again, Mel. I think she froze.
No, her eyes are moving. Mel?
I'm stuck a little bit.
She got stuck a little bit.
Mm-hmm. So I want to ask about your relationship counseling.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
I want to talk about how you got into that and like, how was that like, how did that even start? Like, are couples, can they talk to you about anything? Like, can they call you? Like, what's that?
Well, I got involved. I started it because I divorced in 2019, August 21st, I believe it was 2019. Mm-hmm. And so I'm like, I can't keep doing, you know, is it me that's doing something wrong? Mm-hmm. I don't know, right? Mm-hmm. So I was like, I need to find out. Mm-hmm. I ain't want to talk to no women. Like, no, I know how we think. I think I know how we think.
Mm-hmm.
I've heard how we think. Mm-hmm. I said, I'm creating this podcast specifically for men.
Mm.
My platform is for men. So the females, the women can hear the perspective of a man. Yeah.
Okay.
That's how I started. So,
and I had the benefit of being on the show before.
Mm-hmm. You know, yeah. I have a friend of mine who helped me come up like with the title, because we would talk about all kind of stuff. And so...
It's really to understand how men think, what do they want, what do they expect, how to basically understand their mind so that we can be better women for men to be in better situations or relationships with them.
That too. And if you end the relationship, now you can hear, because right now you ain't hearing him.
Okay.
So let's get another perspective
right.
from somebody you don't even know. Let's hear what he says. So you're really actually hearing, and I would say, the mind and heart of that man from a different perspective.
So tell me, what things are, is there anything that you feel that you have come to know about the male species since the podcast started that you didn't know before?
Hunty, I was like, I'm not dating no more. That's how I was feeling. I'm like, I don't even know if I want to date anymore, because it was so much information, just so much I was hearing. I was like, nah. Then I'm like, you know what? You're going to be all right. You just got to listen, Okiymo. Just got to listen. And that's important. You know, the other thing I learned, you have a man and a woman. They think different. They are different. Right. They're completely, we're different.
Yeah.
And we got to learn how to communicate.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody communicates differently.
Right.
Yeah.
Don't nobody want to be told what to do. You're not their mama.
That's right.
You're not their daddy. So it's the way that you have to communicate with one another.
Mm-hmm.
What I've learned through other, because I, you know, prior to me being married, I used to go to workshops. I used to go to retreats. Those are helpful.
Yeah.
Even if your partner don't get nothing out of it, somebody gonna get something.
Yeah. Right.
So one thing I like and I tell people about is the five love languages. And then there's a personality assessment out there. Mm-hmm. I've shared this before. So I learned a lot about myself through those assessments, and then give them to the person that you're dating.
Mm-hmm.
So my love language is gifting. And some reason it works inside out. Mm-hmm. However, if somebody was to give me a gift, I'm like, ooh, thank you. You know what I'm saying? That's my love language. Now, for a guy, some I've learned is physical touch. That don't always mean sex. It could be holding hands, just being close to each other, massages, you know what I'm saying? But that's going to cause you to really put that person first in your life and be selfless.
Mm-hmm.
If you can't, don't get in a relationship if you're not ready to be selfless.
So when does your podcast air, Okiymo? What day and what time and what platform?
I use StreamYard. It streams through Facebook.
Okay.
And I do it every Thursday at 7. Thursday. And I do make accommodations. So that's the main focus. But I also have single panels on there.
Wow. Okay.
I also have mental health panels on there. And so now I'm about to add couples, whether they're married or single.
I like that.
so they can hear that, you know, their perspectives too.
Mm-hmm. That's interesting. I would love to see a couples one.
Yeah, that's
and how and how they work it out after they leave the show.
Okay. Hello, somebody.
Right, right.
Like at the beginning, and then maybe some seasoned couples.
Yeah.
I talked to a family member whose husband has parents that's been married for 50 years.
Yeah.
Wow.
They asked, you know, what's the secret sauce to y'all being together so long? And they said, simply respect.
What did they say?
Respect.
50 years is a long time. That's a long
time. That is. That's a blessing.
That is a long time.
Wow. That's beautiful. Nowadays, you hope for 5 years.
Hello, somebody.
You hope for five.
I had to charge up my
50 is a whole nother language.
It is. What is that? The silver anniversary?
Yeah, that's silver.
That's a silver. Okay.
Yeah, that's a silver.
Y'all hope and pray when we get married, we can stay together forever. 50 years is definitely a milestone.
Yeah.
You know, the kids staying together, you know, some people don't want to put in the, I call it the love work. When you say work, it's like a, you think of a job and how many people like their job. But you know what I'm saying? But I'm just charging up. Okay. So you would say, some people say that's work. Relationships are work. But I'm like, when you love somebody and you care for somebody, it's not work. It's I love you enough for us to work through whatever it is that we're going to, that we're going through.
Yeah. To fix it. Yeah.
To fix it.
Yeah.
And then for the dating piece, because I deal with singles. Mm-hmm. I'm like, so what is your goal? Everybody right. has a goal.
Right.
In any relationship they're in, there's a goal. If you don't have one, then you need to develop one. And then my other part to it is don't make choices for me. Don't make choices for me. Hunty, that's the worst thing you can do is make a decision and make choices for me. If you just want to lay in play, say you want to lay in play. I'm just saying, don't string me along just to lay down.
Right. Don't fake the funk. Say what you want.
Be transparent.
Be honest. Yeah.
Be honest. Be transparent. And then things can happen.
That song you playing right now, that's a song, like you said, the song I played for you that you didn't hear. I never heard that song until my wife played it one day. And I fell in love with it and downloaded and put it in my car. That was Tony Braxton, right?
Yes.
I love that song.
What song is that? Turn that up song. Yeah.
And that's the
key. Some heat lately. She got a new song with, is it Chemistry she got a song with? Or somebody she got a song with that's new? You know what I'm talking about?
You gotta, it's okay, because a lot of my songs, again, has come from me servicing the people.
That's a ballroom song, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It sounds like it would be.
Can you ballroom, Chris?
Actually, no.
Oh, okay.
But I'm willing to learn. But
yeah, that's good. I'm going to send you a link of this couple. They have an 8-week session for couples that they just started where you can come as a couple and take lessons.
Wow. Yeah. That'll be fly.
Yeah. So.
That'll be fly. I wanted to do it because they used to have it downtown at this other restaurant. It was a bar or whatever. But actually, a guy I know, he teaches ballroom dancing. But send me the link. Yeah, I want to check that out.
Okay.
Okiymo, you ballroom?
Oh yeah, I took classes.
I took classes
before the pre. Listen, him and his wife. Let me see. Smooth. I took smooth classes down at club yesterday.
So isn't he at Mumford?
Yeah, they closed yesterday's during the pandemic.
Okay.
So him and his wife.
Yeah, I know you're talking about dark skin guy.
I took the beginner's class and advanced class. COVID hit, like I had probably like two more sessions left. But he sent me my certificate, and I'm so happy I did because I love dancing. And it's
wait a minute, he gave you an actual certificate?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Wow. I was proud too.
But
that's
no,
my second certificate.
I don't know if y'all knew about this Okiymo and Chris, but back in the day when I was going to Wayne State, I was doing like, you know how you can do work study, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I did a work study program, and I was like a college advisor over at Mumford. So Wayne State would send me over there to help kids get into higher education. I would help them with their FAFSAs and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, tell me why one of the, I guess, courses that they had was ballroom dancing. They had a whole gymnasium of seniors and juniors ballrooming, and it was actually like a class, and they had to come in there and like do it, like
and you know it's good.
I've never seen that before,
because so many schools, they should bring it and put it in schools now. So many schools, they don't have electives like that where they can actually get some exercise and move and do things.
Yeah
they should put that in. Yeah.
At one of my schools, it was Timbuktu Academy, now called Barack Obama Academy.
Mm-hmm.
What Miss Smiley, Mama Smiley did was, in order for the children to have the dance, they had to learn to ballroom because they didn't want them doing all of those.
All that freaky stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And honey, it was beautiful.
It is beautiful. I love seeing it the way, and it really kind of gets back to like the relationship stuff about how women kind of have to submit to the man. The mm-hmm. man takes the lead. He gets to spend the woman around, and she has to follow his lead to dance with him, really.
Honey, if you cannot...
Like, all those things like that kind of, like, I think, innately that we're supposed to do that we kind of don't do, that we got to really do if we want to keep our relationship. It's look, how to communicate and how to let him lead and how to kind of just compliment what he's leading you to do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you know what's hard?
Well, see, we know
sometimes they still struggle, and you might have to guide them.
Oh,
even in ballroom, you still might have to
just help them out a bit.
Help them out a little bit, because they can feel if you're about to take over.
Oh,
but you know, leading to me is not meaning is not dominating.
Okay,
I don't think it's dominating. Just like I don't think being in agreement is like being totally submissive. I think, you know, but then again, I think it's okay for both sides to sometimes submit. There's nothing wrong with it. I mean, I submit a whole hell of a lot here. I mean, you know, sometimes you just gotta roll with it. It is what it is.
Both partners submit.
Yeah, just submit. Mm-hmm. Be done with it. It makes life so much easier sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Just a love of serving one another in love.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Exactly. Exactly. So now I heard two. Okay, I'm gonna share with you two quotes, right? One of them came from Melody, right? When she said, "There must be a gap in your understanding in a conversation." I thought that's profound, right? To say that, like, I really never thought of that, and I could have said that on many days to many people, right? And not to be offensive, but I truly think there's like a gap in your understanding. The other one I heard, I was in a meeting at work,
mm-hmm.
and the person said, "Enjoy the balance of your day."
Mm-hmm.
I said, "Wow,
that's powerful."
Yeah.
Enjoy the balance of your day. I said, I never heard that. But what was scary is when I called a principal the other day and I said, "Hey, how you doing, sir?" He said, "Fair in the middling." Now that's something, fair in the middling. Yeah, it's a thing, fair in the middling. My father said that all the time. So when he said that, I literally sat there and froze. I didn't know what to say because I hadn't heard that since my father died.
Wow.
Yeah, and that was profound. Like,
wow.
Took you back.
Hey, Dad. That's what that was.
Yeah.
That's what that was. I'm here. But I'm gone now. I just wanted to say hi to you real quick and I'm out.
Right.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Because I talked to too many people and that's never been said. So I'm sharing those two things with you. but the balance of your day I thought was profound. So I'm gonna say that to people when I hang up the phone from them now. Hey, enjoy the balance of your day.
Yeah, and it goes back to what Okiymo was saying, is that kind words, things that you respect, little phone say to kind of uplift each other.
And look, let's what's that you playing?
Peebo Bryson. All I wanna do. All I wanna do is you.
Turn that up.
Hey, turn that up. Let's go. Let's party time.
This another ballroom song.
DJ Quad in the house on the Real Nonsense Podcast. Hey.
About to switch it up just a little.
Okay, right, let's go. Hey, let's go. It's your party.
Get you a pen or something for this next song. Okay. All right. So I need all the singers in the house. To join in with me.
Hey.
I love karaoke. This is my favorite song to sing during karaoke, y'all.
Okay.
Let's go.
Sing it, Okiymo.
I'll join the chorus.
Okay.
Okay. Hey. I saw you standing. And I started pretending that I knew. All right. And you knew me too. Hey, let's go. And just like you were too shy, but you were the only one, so was I. And I love you.
Take us home, Okiymo. Hey. karaoke night on the Real Nonsense Podcast with DJ Quad.
Love, love,
love. Hey, there we go.
For a minute.
Hey, baby.
Okay. And then we'll switch it up a little.
Go ahead.
I'm going to take it back.
It's amazing that Tevin Campbell is eternal. Okay.
Okay.
Tevin Campbell is eternal,
this is
man.
How we do it.
And so is Montel.
Look.
Yo, yo, yo. That's frat.
This is how we do it.
True Kappa Man, Montel Jordan.
Okay.
And I feel all right. The party's here on the west side.
Let's go.
Let's go. Let's turn it up. Real Nonsense with DJ Quad.
Faded. It feels so good in my hood tonight.
I need a drink of some wings, man. It's time to get going. Party in the house, like, oh. So we rocking out today. It's Saturday. The Real Nonsense Podcast with Chris and Mel. With our guest, Okiymo, the counselor, aka DJ Quad.
Okay, DJ Quad. When the people want to get in contact with you, how can they contact you to book you for your services?
Well, my number is 313-580-1292. I'm on Instagram as DJ Quad. And on my Facebook, it's Okiymo Manica EDS, but I also have a DJ Quad page on there too.
Okay.
That's Instagram at DJ Quad.
At DJ Quad on Instagram.
At DJ Quad.
And then my email is djquad@gmail.com.
Email is djquad@gmail.com.
Hey.
I feel like I'm sitting in the club trying to get the bartender attention.
I know, right?
Let me look. Now you
hey, I'm tapping on the bar. Like, hey.
For real though. Now you know what year this is. You know what it is.
Hey. Put a hump in your back and say, hey.
Simma Gamera, sorority incorporated, 1922, let's go, our centennial, that blue and gold.
Oh.
Hey, yeah, you already know.
mile. Let's go.
Hey. Hey, Ricky.
Hey, they ain't ready.
Hey, listen. I can't even hate. So listen, Okiymo, it's been fun. It's been a pleasure.
Yes.
And I hate that this hour goes by so quick sometimes with so many people that we talk to. It's like it seems like we just started talking, and all of a sudden it's time to go. Oh, and the book. Hold on, let's show the books. So again, now and she is a published author as well. So can you hold the books up a little closer so the audience can see the titles of the book?
Uh-oh.
So yep. So we got Music Is My World, and what's the other one? And we have
The Winner's Circle.
The Winner's Circle.
Let's make sure we get the links. Okiymo, make sure you email us the links to how to order
the books.
So
yeah.
We put them in this production, I guess, when Chris, we upload this.
Absolutely. We'll put the links in there. So this has been another great episode of the Real Nonsense Podcast with Okiymo, the counselor, a.k.a. DJ Quad.
Yes.
With Chris and Mel.
Yes.
Well, we make it make sense. Absolutely.
Make it make
so we going out. We going out with the music. So turn it up, DJ. Let's go out with the music. Wow.
Right.
Exciting.
Peace out, y'all.
Peace.